Ciao ragazzi, io sono Falconero e oggi sono qua con un nuovo video di Observer che è decisamente diverso da come me lo sarei immaginato. Questo perché ci siamo accorti di aver avuto un piccolo problema troppo tardi. Abbiamo registrato circa 2 ore di Observer per poi accorgerci che si era praticamente compromesso tutto al di là del solo gameplay, per cui sia le nostre facce sia le nostre voci sono scomparse dalla registrazione. Per fortuna non abbiamo ancora finito il gioco, ringraziando il cielo. Non siamo andati fino in fondo, però una buona parte dovrò proporvela e ve la proporrò oggi in maniera un po' diversa, in maniera un po' più narrativa. Spero che comunque le cose vi piacciono. E fermo restando che appunto il finale ce lo godremo insieme, salvo ulteriori colpi di scena, nel prossimo episodio. Per cui adesso vi lascio a quello che è successo affinché possiate un po' scoprire tutto l'orrore a cui abbiamo assistito noi negli ultimi giorni.
Hey, is everything all right? Don't mind the rain? It burns sometimes. And this helps?
Not tonight.
Do you know who owns the tattoo parlor?
Tenant.
What? He lives here? In this building? Where?
Jack Garnes. Apartment 210. Second floor.
Thanks. Don't get your wires wet.
Need to get out.
You will.
Dan sembra stia perdendo completamente la testa perché dopo serie visioni immotivate realizza di essersi collegato neurologicamente a un chirurgo clandestino senza conservarne però alcun ricordo. Le informazioni che emergono da questa ennesima sessione di connessione neurale sono tante e difficili da comprendere, ma una cosa è chiara. Dietro a questo traffico di protesi, organi e tessuti si cela qualcosa di terribilmente oscuro.
Thank you, Doctor.
Why specialize in augmentation?
To go beyond our limits. To realize our true potential. To usher in a new era.
Big words. Some would say it's all about improving the patient's quality.
Mommy! Mommy!
Hold it steady, goddammit. Tissue inflammation. It's rejecting the implant.
Connected for 16 minutes and 43 seconds, real time.
16 minutes? Am I losing it? Already scanned. Focus down. Try to remember.
Warning. Abnormal genetic structure detected.
This blood doesn't match the victim's. Calibrated trace.
Calibrating now. Calibration complete. Trace established.
Bingo.
Da lì in poi la situazione peggiora drasticamente, rendendo il confine tra visioni e realtà oggettiva sempre più labile, impossibile da definire. Cosa sta accadendo? Qual è la verità e soprattutto cos'è davvero reale? Le domande restano senza risposta finché Dan non si imbatte finalmente nel killer, in un drammatico faccia a faccia.
What the hell are you, anyway? Time to get some answers. Setting up a crime scene.
Sopravvissuto fortunosamente a un incontro che avrebbe potuto determinare la sua fine, Dan riesce finalmente a scoprire la vera identità del killer attraverso l'ennesimo, rischiosissimo collegamento neurale. Ma non tutto ciò che vede, o meglio, che rivive, porta alle risposte che ci aspettavamo.
Lucky me. The neural implant's still functional. Mostly. God knows why you fucking kill people. But I want my fucking son back.
Once upon a time, there lived in a certain village a little country girl, the prettiest creature who was ever seen.
Something's not right. Just look at it. I don't have time for this.
Victor! Victor!
He had cut only a few strokes when he saw the red cap shining through. He cut a little more, and the girl jumped out and cried, "Oh, I was so frightened. It was so dark inside."
Mommy, why did the wolf have to die?
Yeah. What's wrong with his leg?
little freak!
Watch your fucking step. Hey, get him. Here. Fucking freak. Get out of here.
Victor. Victor.
Come, Victor. Dinner is ready.
Yes. You're on the right path. We're almost done.
Please, you need to eat. Come on, eat. Eat.
Eat. Hurry! Your prey's getting away!
This is hopeless.
There. Now's your chance. Hurry.
Partial to complete paralysis? Great idea, Dad.
God damn it. And he did that? Why? Just to spite me? I told you to stay out of the stacks.
I'm better off there than I am
here.
Stop yelling. You're only making it worse.
I'm making it worse? Look at him! It's grotesque! It's disgusting! This freak of nature is not my son!
Victor, please. Your father didn't mean it. We're just worried about you, that's all.
Once upon a time, there lived in a certain forest a brave little wolf, the fiercest creature who was ever seen.
Okay, Victor. Please, calm down.
Mommy?
Talk to him, Victor. I know there is still hope.
Not like this. Jesus, this is hopeless.
Look, he's at it again.
You're embarrassing me.
We're in for another show.
Look at him.
Just give up already.
Oh, it's just fucking sad.
No.
Look at him. Please.
Once upon a time, there lived in a certain
village. We're past the first phase of the treatment, and it looks promising. Your body is responding well to the genetic material.
Thank you, Doctor. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it.
Oh, that's all right. You'll thank me in a couple of weeks when the shift starts to occur. I'm sure you'll be pleased with the results.
So you see, while it is technically inoperable, this procedure can practically nullify the symptoms. I'm not going to lie, the treatment is invasive, but it is by far the best option.
Oh, thank you, Doctor. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it. Did you hear that, Dan?
It should have been you.
Once in your life, can't you just admit that you're wrong?
better stay here. There might be some very nasty people out there. Stay!
You don't. He finds you. He always gets his prey.
Three pairs of eyes, 4 gallons of plasma, 2 hearts, 2 livers, a set of lungs. A pretty decent yield.
He's always out there, watching, waiting.
Dan decide così di mettersi alla ricerca della tana del killer nella speranza di scoprire qualcosa in più, ma questa è una storia che scopriremo insieme la prossima volta.